Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to go straight to the point because I want to talk about something very, very, very dear to my heart. I'm actually dressed to go out soon, but I needed this to go up. Recently I put out a tweet. I don't know how recent that was, depending on when this video will go up, but I put out a tweet talking about compromise, talking about how there's this thing that's happening now where the lines between right and wrong are very, they're blurred, they're becoming blurred with every passing second. So now things that used to be obviously outrightly not okay are now becoming more okay. The other day I was on the internet and I saw that pedophilia is now, you know, becoming a thing. And this video is not to talk about, you know, what should be and what people shouldn't do. This video is to remind you that the word of God is always our standard. And I wanted to make this video not to reiterate what I said in, you know, the tweet. I'll try and see if I can put up the tweet somewhere on the screen. But the whole purpose of this video is to tell you that you shouldn't compromise. If God has said something in his word about what he wants to do or what he wants you to be or how he wants you to behave or act, that is the standard. That will always be the standard. God is not the kind of God that would change his mind. He's not going to change his standard. It's always going to be that. He's always going to say, this is what I want and this is how I want it to be done. I've been thinking a lot about, you know, believers in Christ that were persecuted. I mean, right now, there's a persecution going on in Southern Kaduna. So I've been thinking a lot about persecution. I've been asking myself time and time and time again that if a gun was put to my head, if a knife was put to my throat, will I choose God? Will I say yes to Jesus? Will I say yes to him when, you know, when the odds are against me, basically? Am I still going to say, yes, I choose Jesus. Yes, I want him. Yes, I want to serve him. And that's really important to me because, like I said, the devil is very active. The devil is very alive. And now you realize that it's a subtle thing where they are gradually beginning to normalize things that probably shouldn't be normalized. And now it's the way to go. And you find yourself in a place where, when you don't agree with what they say, when you're not in the place where you're saying, okay, this is what they say, and you're not going with it, where you're not doing the usual or the normal, you start to feel like the unusual one. You start to feel like, am I doing too much? You start to feel like, am I carrying this God thing on my head? You start to feel like, why am I not overdoing at this point? But I'm making this video to encourage you, to let you know that you are not doing too much, to let you know that God's standard will never change. When he said this is it, it will always be it. He will not wake up one day and change his mind. God is not schizophrenic. He's not, I'm this person one day and I'm another person another day. God's word is a standard. It will always be. Another encouragement I wanted to give is that I don't know, wherever, in whatever capacity you are serving, let your light shine. The Bible says the instruction that Jesus gave to his disciples was go into the world and let me, you know, make me known. He tells us that we have work to do. We have so much work to do. If the devil is intensifying his efforts, we too will intensify our efforts, meaning we will preach more, we will pray for souls more, we will reach out more. If you write books, you will write books that will change lives. If it's a blog post, if it's a poem, you will write things that will make a difference. If you're singing songs, we're singing songs to make God known. We're doing more for the gospel. We're doing so much more. We're not giving up. I want this video to be short. It is just a really short charge. It's just an encouragement. I want this video to stir you up. I want this video to wake something up on your inside. I want that after you finish watching this video, you pick up that thing that God has asked you to do and you do it with diligence because you understand that you are shaping culture, you are influencing tradition. God is raising an army for him that is unshakable, an army for him that is stubborn in their faith, an army for him that stands. I sent out a newsletter recently that talked about how this Korean series I'm watching, I mean, this is an aside, but if you don't watch Korean series, you're really missing out on amazing storylines. Anyway, this Korean series I'm watching and how these people, these people stood to fight for their country. So it was about how the Korean Empire used to be the Joseon Empire, Joseon Dynasty, and there was this time when the Japanese came and they took over, and there was a war and all of that. But there were these set of Joseon people who stood firm and said, this is it, we will fight. These people never had a crown, never had an applause, never had, nobody knew what they were doing, but they were in the shadows and they were fighting. These people went to war for, you know, their country. And I'm not saying go to war for your country. We die daily to things that we probably shouldn't be dying daily to. But like Paul said, I am crucified with Christ. And the life that I live now, I live not, you know, I live by faith in the Son of God, knowing, understanding that your life is not your own, understanding that your life is precious, understanding that you're called to so much more. Oh my God, so much more than you're already doing. You're called to so much. There's so much that God wants to do in you and through you, and He's going to do it if you just surrender yourself to Him. If you just say, God, I'm here. God, I'm available. God, whatever it is you want to do, I say yes. I'm saying, use me here and now. And it doesn't even, I say this to say, it doesn't even have to be in big ways, right? When we talk about God using you, think about grand stages, think about traveling the world, telling people, even if it's one person, right? You just do it. David was serving an audience of one, an audience of sheep for a while before he even got to the palace. Even if it's an audience of one, I want you to give it your all. Maybe you're writing a blog post and you're thinking, only two people read my post. For those two people, continue to give it your all. Pour your all as though you were pouring it to 1,000 people. Pour your all as though you were serving 1,000 people. If only one person gets to read your work, do it. Continue to do it. And this is what diligence is. You continue and you continue. And God honors diligence. God honors diligence. And He would not crown your diligence. It's not like, okay, when I serve one person, one day 1,000 people will come and then I will continue. It may not always be that. You might never get a crowd of 10,000. You might never get somebody to applaud you. You might never even get anybody saying, well done, oh, you've done amazing. You might never get that. But I want it to be enough for you. I want it to be enough for you that God sees you and applauds you. I want it to be enough for you that you are serving the King of Kings. I want it to be enough for you. Again, I said I wanted it to be short, so I'm just going to wrap it up here, and I'm just going to summarize saying that the devil is active. The devil is he's on an agenda, and he's not using, you know, black horns or scary things like we see in the movie. He's not coming, you know, in the way that we know that he would normally come. No, the devil has changed scheme, right? And he's coming in a subtle way. He's coming after people's minds. He's coming after mindsets. He's coming after behaviors. He's coming after life patterns. And we have to be alert to these things. We have to be awake to these things. So we have to devote more time in prayer, and not just even in prayer, just actively being active in our spheres of influence. Wherever it is that you are serving, I want you to give it your all as though God was in front of you and you were doing it for Jesus, because whatever you do, you know, do as unto the Lord. Okay, that's about it. I hope this stirred you up. I hope this encouraged you. I hope this spoke to you in some way, any way possible, because yes, we are soldiers of God and we are on a mission, the mission of reconciliation. We're reconciling the world to God, and we won't stop until the world hears of Him, until everybody knows, you know, hears about this beautiful gospel. If you've gotten to this point of my video and you mean, who is this Jesus guy? What did he do? What is the gospel? I want you to please send me a message. I'd like to pray with you. I'd like to talk to you. If you want to, you know, get to know this Jesus, you want to serve Him, you want to take your spiritual life more seriously, you want to do more for God, you know you can do more, but you think that you're not doing enough, please give me a message. Hit me on any of my social media platforms, or send me an email. I'll put my email in the description box. Reach out to me. I want the best for you. I want you to know of this beautiful gospel, because in as much as we talk about people using the fear tactic, the truth is Jesus is coming back. And I mean, only those who believe in Jesus will go to heaven. It's a fact. It's something that's going to happen. Although that it's not your sin that will make you go to hell, But if you do not believe in Jesus, you will not make it. And I want you to make it. I want the best for you. Do you see that I love you? Yes. So reach out to me. Don't hesitate. I don't bite. I'm really friendly. Share this with everybody you think needs to hear this. I love you guys. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.